Good. Raise your hands for question.
Yes.
Kim?
Well done, guys. Rusty, is it fair to say that tonight was one of those nights where there were a lot of mistakes, a lot of errors, a lot of things that are coachable with wrong tonight?
Was it happened? Is that the word you used during the week about the press conference?
Yeah.
Was it haphazard?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think the performance was haphazard.
Do you feel it was like the uncoachable things, like character and heroism and those sort of things that
No, I thought the guys did really well against the New Zealand team, played well, and to win at the end, New Zealand dominated the whole game. And our boys had a few opportunities, but for long spells we were out of the game. And luckily at the end, the boys pulled it through.
Do you feel like there was a bit like musical chairs in that game and it was a bit disruptive, you know, with the changes in the various positions and starts when that one off and on again?
Yeah, unfortunately, you know, I can control the fracture or whatever is in his face, and when a guy get concussion and they are going down, and you know, you can't control injuries. If that happens, you know, the ref must stop the game. He's not a medical doctor, so if their doctor goes on, he must respect that, and if our doctor goes on, you know, he must respect that. I do agree. I do felt sometimes that it was long periods, but I mean, luckily the guys stayed focused during that, and so to the All Blacks. I mean, this game could have, we all know, could have gone the other way, and they certainly would have not been deserving it if they won this game.
Yeah, you guys were cheering for making ballots in South Africa and international. Can you take us through what that felt like a bit?
No, it was. No, we knew before the time because we knew the game was sold out a couple of months ago. And I think it's not just here getting to the stadium. I think we've got the privilege of driving down the street and we see people from different walks of life. And what Coach Rassie always talks to us, you know, whenever we were about to play, he doesn't speak a lot about technical stuff. He just speaks why we're playing. And we see that people who live in the streets, how crazy they go when they see it. You know, and then come into the stadium and seeing how South Africa come out, South Africans come out for that. That's what keeps us going. You know, yes, we have a lot of things that we play for personally, but like, South Africans are what gives us the motivation. So it was really beautiful today.
But I think just a word on the performance of Bussy and Shepard.
Like I tried to say that at Tuesday's press conference, you know, we want to get, I hope that came across all right, Ken, at Tuesday's press conference that, you know, we wanted those guys to experience that this level. And can they handle it, you know? And that's how you learn the characters. And I think Fassi came through flying colors. I think Sasha came through, you know, but that's not to say Andre is out of it or Mani is out of it. You know, we're going to keep on building squads as long as we're winning. We know tonight we could have lost this game easy. And Sasha was even emotional in the change room afterwards. So for us, it's big. New Zealand's big. And for players to step up from one tier, even a tier two nation to a tier one nation, and then number one and two in the world, Ireland, and then the All Blacks, who's just an amazing team. For players to perform, it takes guys like this to do it in games like that. And yeah, I think all the guys, even Ben Jason, you know, we were feeling sorry for Peter Steph. He played 4, 5, 7. He later said he didn't know his name anymore. He was just, So even Ben Jason was a tactical sub to get Peter a bit of rest. So we're very happy with all the youngsters at play.
Coach, how crucial was this victory in terms of, you know, keeping on to, you know, prolong that gap between yourself and New Zealand for the rugby championship, and you believe the big Cape Town at the moment. Do you know the championship in
Zealand? No, it's listen, at one stage there were 3 tries up and looking at a bonus point, 5 pointer for them. So at that stage we just wanted to get them not getting a bonus point, and then the boys got into it. So yeah, I think, you know, the rugby championship is very important and we would love to win it, but we will definitely try a few new players next week again and hopefully they make it. We are under no illusions that maybe we're well placed now. I don't know what Argentina and Australia is going to do. You know, that's going to be very interesting. If Argentina win 2 games, they settle in the picture. So, yeah, we won't get ahead of ourselves. You know, we'll go and look at this game, look at why we couldn't get out of our half at stages, and look at why we couldn't capitalize the few times when we were there. So, no, we'll just look at next week. We've got too much respect for all that.
Yep.
Rassie, just for clarity, you said fracture in the face. Were you talking about
Siya? It looks like a fracture to me. I'm not a medical doctor, and I apparently explained the Evans injury not great on Tuesday, but I think it's a fracture.
It's something you're going to look into
later on. Yeah, no, the doc will definitely have to look at it. He doesn't normally look like this.
It
looks a bit better.
Yeah,
looks a bit better.
Make it worse.
I don't know, Rashford,
but I assume
maybe you can ask about
10 minutes
ago, 10 points down. Did you ever
believe it? I was in the inside, but I did. Yeah, I was doing my HIA, but to be honest, whenever we're on the field, we understand the people that are watching will probably feel that, but while you still, you have got time in your hand, and we've been in far worse, like where we're behind by a lot. So we've been able to be in front and come back. And the great thing I'm saying to the guys afterwards, like when they scored first in the second half, we came together like, okay, cool, amazing, intercept, let's go to the next play. Nobody panics. And it's Eben, if he's not talking, it's Peter Steph or it's the next guy. Even the guys that have played two caps, you know, they're coming, don't worry, don't panic, ground is ordering guys around. That's what I'm enjoying about this team, is that coach gives everybody license. He says, your rugby knowledge doesn't count on your caps. It's all about if you know something, we can say, and that's what was great about our team today.
Yes, sir. You spoke about playing for the nation, playing for everybody else, the community, but the clubs you could hold, you just didn't hold that flag today. How did that feel for the Springboks Kolisi family?
All right,
what's better chat today?
Yeah, it was special. It was really special. The last time she did it, we didn't really know each other, so we fist pumped and said, give each other a nice hug. You know, I wanted to have her next to me to sing the national anthem. I'm really proud of her. The way she finished her career and how much she, you know, she loves South Africa, and she performs for South Africa as well. She's the most decorated South African Olympian. So yeah, it was really special, and it's a moment that the family is going to talk about for a while. The next bride, of course.
Yeah, it looked like the game was just so frenetically paced and absorbing. Just how difficult, where does that rank in the most intense matches that you've played in
Johannesburg? It's hard to do that now. I'm going to have to look at it, but I must say, we knew the coaches prepared us, and we know what it's like for them. The last time we won both games, and we've been there. They beat us in Auckland, and we played in London. We had to get up for that, and we knew how it was going to be. And games like this, like you just know, you know, they're just written in the start, and we wouldn't take it any other way. You know, it was difficult to fight like that, but yeah, it's one of the top ones definitely for us.
No, it's true. And it was a lot from one was a great was a mole try, a great mole try, which I think Jasper, who hasn't played for a while, just missed his role in how to stop that specific one. But that can be understood after 3.5 months not playing. And then the other three tries was from great turnovers where we tried to offload the one and our defense wasn't quite set. And they didn't even punish you the most of that. So I think we actually defended really well when it was structured. And it was from the one scrum that got a lot of yardage. But I think turnover attack was probably the one that put us meet the most.
Last finish question, Anna.
Rassie,
can you give us a
update
on the injury that quickly sustained? You know,
that's concussion.
Guys, what we're
talking
about is into eschalanga mandla kuwina la Freedom Cup obviously sifuna ukwina championship and ibalekile kakhulu like since 2009 sangisayibamba lanto so small section town and say, "Hazi, nazo besithetha kahle ni island Caspers winner lo isibini into ebalekile ukuthi siliqeme sifuna ukuthi make sure because siya build nje ne but niza zilefuna ukukhupha emva komqolo wakho so as polanga zonyenzeleke so celebrate nje kancinci then sephinde siyasebenza lo vixayo sposo
Ik boek het zo af op kritieke tijden van het boek en was altijd zo keer af te zien, maar in ieder geval de dikste weer.
Ja, dat doen. Weet je, ons speelt voor allemaal in Zuid-Afrika en ons sê dit baie keer, maar as dit deurkom in die game, dan is dit waar. Jy weet, mense kan dit sê, jy kan dit praat, jy kan, ek vat dinsdag, ek is eintlik so teleurgesteld, ek het gedog, jy weet, as mense by 'n persconferentie lekker openlik is, en ek sien baie van julle Suid-Afrikaanse supporters wat media is, en lekker open eerlik is, en goeders verduidelik, jy weet, dan voel dit, mense doen ook iets vir julle, wat korrek moet media berigte doen, en julle is ook Suid-Afrikaners, ek weet, daar is oorseese media ook natuurlik hierso, en ongelukkig, tyker buiten jou en mense kom tot gevolgtrekkings wat nie noodwendig die waarheid was nie, maar jy probeer daardoor ook met mense communikeer, nader aan mense kom, en met julle wat hier so sit, close raak, en as die span speel so gespeeld, ek kon makkelijk hier gesit het vandaan, nou is jylle kon ons makkelijk gewen het, en ek kon nie gesit het om die klomp mense kon gesit, ja, jy is by wind gehad by dinsdag persconferentie, maar ek dink nie, mense moet my dink, ons sal wind gehad wees, hierdie span weet waarvoor hulle speel, hulle weet nie wie hulle speel, en hulle te veel respect vir die mense in Suid-Afrika, en vir julle as media, en vir die All Blacks, weet, so, ja, ek dink die karakter was krik.
Was jy net kort, ek sal opkom, ek sal nie wees, maar jy opkom,
nie, nee, ek dink het was die great nie, jy weet, ek dink is a great occasion geweest. Ek bedoel, flippe, dit is a game waar hulle vinnig gescoor het, ons hulle maklike try gegeet, waar Damien het die bal tussen hom en Siya, hulle het die derde keer in die rij gedoen, obviously toe, dan is het gelees, en dan was hier daar twee tries van turnovers, van op die stadium was hulle drie tries voor om die bonuspunt, waar ons 5 punten geweest het, en ons was 10 elk op die lot nou. So, vir ons om te wen is groot eer op, maar die ouwe spelers verdien baie krediet, allemaal vir wat het ons halftijd gesê, absoluut niks. Ouwe sit maar net een paar gekies uitgewees, hulle het paar goeie plannen gemaakt.
Last two questions.
Rassie, jy moet my broeke af. Ek kan net een bykie daar word gepraat, maar wat is jy plan en die spelers een bykie teruggevat door die verrassing wat die Nieuw-Zeelanders bring het in eerste 20 minuten, en is dit al hoe gelijk dat hulle bykie gesikkel het in my 20 minuten?
Nee, ek dink, het kan seker wees dat een paar van die ouwens gesikkel het, maar ek dink, ou moet onthou dat, ou soos Roan, eerste keer een olmerk toets speel, hy gaan sy voete nog moet vind, Sasha gaan sy voete nog moet vind, en ou eet selfs, wat sy naam, Fassi, Apelele, en kies, ek dink, die eerste 10 minuut het Apelele gewys, hoe die twee tackles, die ene hoek en die andere hoek, en die ongelukkige die geel kaart gekry, dat fysisk is hulle reg, mentally gaan hulle net beter word, en ja, seker, die All Blacks shock jou altyd so bykie, maar ek dink die ouwens het het geabsorbeer en toe omgedraai.
No, they are see a very cool and Lendo if coaching staff if you yenza Lendo and is a bandle class win class kiwa is a bandle yeah and onge I'm like zozongi players that's mana I amatuba zia utato I mean and tina sisi players to make sure but buyers basi abapeka and once all coach abantu ithuba bayazithatha ngelelo ngezandla zombini and into ebalulekileyo siyenza ezi changes zenzekayo akho mntu ukhalayo etimini akho mntu ukomplainayo siyasupportana and i-competition benditshilo kevetwela phakathi evekini i-competition yethu ilapha etimini but i-competition e-healthy because siyancedana xa upikiwe namhlanje semva kwakho club that I'm coming to Kalum, you don't need to support the Manta Mong. So, if but Tigalet so and like Tina Banya Vitubatal, as he has was one in, okay, again, go to Sayas, but at least Lal Ababa Zimba go to. Who talent away from me, Lama 2 and talent management, and Nancy Ginenda Kundu Yenzo coach. When I win, but at the same time, Sipin is quite a great lead.
Thank you.